Hi friends, in a previous class we have seen some off-page optimization techniques. We have seen up to this infographic submission. We have seen all these things. Okay, so we have seen up to infographic submission. So up to infographic submission we have seen. Today we are going to learn about these remaining things. Okay, let's go with document submission. Okay, what is this document submission? We have seen directory submission, image submission, video submission like this. We have seen various kind of submissions. In case of directory submission, we'll be going to some directories. The particular directories will be having some websites under it. We'll be leaving our website details and all, and we'll be requesting them to get a backlink. In order to give a backlink, we'll be requesting. So in case of image and video submission, we will be going to such related platforms and we will be submitting our images and videos. Okay, in the same way, in case of document submission, here we submit documents instead of images, videos or infographics. Here we will be submitting some documents like PDFs, PPTs on different websites. Okay, so another important thing is sometimes these documents may appear on search results also, and it is also very good for branding. Okay, so there are various document submission sites. You might have heard about SlideShare like that. Have you heard about SlideShare? You might also have heard about Issue, Mediafire, Script. There are various document submission sites, or else you can come here and search for them. Right. So these are all various document submission sites. Okay. You might have heard about SlideShare. It is very good for branding also. Another important thing is these results will appear on SERP also. Sometimes this document submission might be paid, or sometimes it will be free also. Here what we should do is we should upload some document from our system to this website. So we have to select a file here. In order to do that, you have to sign up initially. So it's okay. So please create an account in SlideShare. After that, you have to upload your thing. Okay. After that, you have to upload a document from your thing to here. The thing is, as this is a kind of a PowerPoint presentation, or it may be a PDF document, people may not read it entirely. Okay. So the thing you have to do is in the first page itself, or in the first slide itself. Okay. Please give your info. Please leave your info, like your website name or your phone number, your details like that. Please leave your info in the first slide or first page itself so that they can call you and contact back. Okay, so we'll not be getting a backlink here. Okay, not be getting a backlink, but we'll be getting good traffic through this, and also our result will be appearing in SERP results also. Right, next thing is classified submission. Okay, so what is this classified submission? Simply posting ads. Okay, or do you people know about OLX, Wika, Suleka? Have you heard?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, so it's a kind of ad posting platform. Okay, we'll be selling and buying some products in OLX also. You might have heard about all these things. Okay, so similarly, we'll also be posting about our business. Okay, in such kind of platforms. And another thing is, from here also we'll not be getting a backlink, but the thing is we may get traffic, and also these results will get appear on SERP. Okay, so as these sites are old and they have a good age, and they'll also be having good domain authority and page authority, our results might show up in SERP results. Okay. Right. Let's go to Quicker or OLX and all. So, or else we might directly search for classified submission. you'll be getting various sites. Go for all those sites and keep posting about your business. It may be trainings or it may be about your products or whatever it may be, you can post there. So these are all various sites. Even click.in is one of the famous sites. Okay, so all these are the list of sites. Okay, so let's go to one thing. I'll go for click.in like such. So because you people know about OLX and all, so I choose click.in. Okay, so you can change your city and all. So here also you can sign up and create an account. Okay, so go to the field. Okay, you might go for thing what you want to post and all. Okay, as I am into education and learning, I'll choose this. So I'm like tuition, professional courses or computer courses, I'll choose one thing. So see, you'll be seeing all these ads. Okay, these are given by top colleges and tutors and all. You can also create your own ad. You have to create an image and all, and you have to post it here. How to create images and all, you'll be learning in later classes. Simply click on post your ad. So in order to post your ad, you must create an account in these platforms also. Okay, I'll choose one more. Education and learning, what is your thing related to? I'll choose something related to me. Okay, now we have to select a city. In what city you'll be training people and all, it will be asking me. So right, so now here you have to upload your photo. So the main thing is here, you'll be first shown with a photo. Your ad will be shown in the form of a photo. Then you'll be giving all the details. So always choose a proper image. As I said before, make sure that your image contain all your business info and all, so that people can contact you directly. Don't make people search for your business and all. So, okay, you can add multiple photos. So what is this course about and all, you can choose. You can choose others also. Okay, you can add multiple images and all. In which locality you'll be teaching, even it is asking like that. Right, you have to give the title. Learn digital marketing. You have to give proper info. So about your business you give. Okay, so you have to provide your email ID so that anyone can contact you for your email ID or mobile number. Okay, I'm giving one mail ID and mobile number. Okay, if you have any landline number, you can give that. So enter the CAPTCHA code and click on post. That's it. Your ad will be posted. I have to fill a field, it seems. So let at least one course. Others, I have added this thing. Okay, you can add multiple courses also. Right, check your email. Okay, your ad is pending. So first they'll review your ad. Okay, they will review your ad once. If it is genuine and if it is okay, they will accept it. Once they accept it, okay, your ad will be posted in this click.in platform. Okay, in the same way, you can post your ads in OLX, Sulekha, okay, JustDial. You might have heard about JustDial also. If you want a hospital also, if you go to JustDial and search for a hospital, it will show you what all hospitals are nearby you like that. Okay, so all these things are platforms only. Okay, these are all ad posting platforms or classified submission things. OLX, Vika, JustDial, Sulekha, you might have also seen now, just now we have seen click.in. Okay, like this, there are various ad posting platforms. Among them, these things are well known. Okay. So again, I am saying the thing is you will not be getting a backlink here, but your ads might get displayed on SERP results. Okay. In SERP, your ads might get up here. So make sure that your image has your business info. Right. Next thing is forum posting. Okay, forum posting, Q&A. Almost both of these things are same. Have you people heard about Quora?
Yes, ma'am. Questions and answers.
You search for any question or any doubt on Google, you'll be displayed with Quora results also, right? So this forum posting or Q&A websites are known as, okay, question and answer website. This is also known as question and answer websites. Usually this forum posting is nothing but they are online discussion sites. There will be some discussion going on and each and every question. Okay, you can post your question, or if anyone asks for anything, you can post your answer. You can suggest this thing like that. Okay, they are like some online discussion sites. Okay, you can ask a question or you can answer a question. Okay, so here it is the best way to bring a good traffic to your website, and also your results will get displayed on SERP. Okay, so these are all some tactics to gain some business. Okay, so let's go to Quora. There are other platforms also. There are other forum posting platforms also. If you want to look for many, you can go and search here, or you can search in Google also. So among them, Quora is one of the well-known one. Okay, these are all various platforms. Among them, Quora is the best one. I'll go for Quora. So again, you can have an account here. Without having an account also, you can see the answers and all. But in order to post an answer, you have to create an account. Another thing is you can also run ads on Quora. Okay, you can also run ads on Quora. I'll also make a video about that. Okay. You might have been scrolling these things. See, this is an ad. Okay, this is an ad in Quora, sponsored ad. Okay, in this way, we can also, this is sponsored ad. We can also create such kind of images and we can also run ads. Okay, we can also advertise ourselves on Quora. But for these things, you have to pay. Okay, so if you see, there are various questions. If someone asks for anything, many people will be answering for it. Okay, so you can search for whatever question you want. If you have any doubt, okay, like what is digital marketing? Based on your topic, whatever you want, you can search for it. So many people might have answered this question also. See, if you see what exactly is digital marketing, someone posted this question and also 985 views it got. Okay, so if you click on this question, you can see the answers also. See, there are many answers. Okay, so if you see how many people upvoted this thing, 2.4k people means, okay, this person got promoted. Okay, he promoted his ad to 2.4k people. Sorry, not his ad, his answer. Okay, see, this much huge amount of audience you can get in Quora. Okay, many views you'll be getting for your business. You can also answer for this question. If you want to answer, simply click on answer. So that you can write your answer here. Okay, so simply the thing is, digital marketing is a promotion of products and services. By making use of online and digital mediums. Okay, like that you can give an elaborate answer also. Okay, so you can also make things bold, italic and all. So give proper answers, as most of the people will look for genuine and correct answers. So please give correct answers. Okay. And next thing is digital marketing. You can also make this thing as bold. In the same way, you can also leave your website details here. Like if you want more info about digital marketing, visit our website. Like that, you can link your leave your link also. If you want to know more about digital marketing, visit us. Like this, you can promote your business also. Simply go here and you can also copy this thing. You can paste it here. Okay. Or else you can make a particular thing as a link also. Simply you have to click a link here and you can you should have give your URL here. Okay. You can give URL like that. I'll give www.digiready.in. Like that, you can give your URL. Okay, so you can also add images. Okay, you can also add images and all. And mainly, this is a kind of text based platform only. Mostly, people will be answering in huge answers. Okay, nowadays, they are able to add some images also. Okay, right. So, simply click on submit. Once you submit, your thing will be posted. Okay, the thing will be posted here. Okay, so see one view you got. So based on this, you can also know how many views you got and all you can. Okay, so like this, you can drive more people to your website. Another thing is you'll be giving a link here so that people may click here and they may navigate to your site. And also your result will be displayed on SERP. Okay, so let's think that there is no query at all. Okay, no question at all, like what is ODMT? If you want to do some branding about your business, okay? No one raised that question till now. So you only raise a question like what is ODMT? Like that, raise a question from one website, okay? See whether people will answer it or not. If no one answers, create another website, then you only give an answer for that, okay? Like that, you can create your own branding. These are all kind of marketing tips and all, okay? So if you want to get more traffic to your website, then raise a query like have a landing page issue like that and give you a website link. At least if 1,000 people sees your query, in order to solve your issue, they'll be clicking on your link and they'll be navigating to your website. Am I correct? Okay, in this way, you'll be getting more and more traffic. Right, so it is, these are all some kind of marketing tips. Okay, so if you want to improve your landing page appearance on all, you can come here and you can leave your link. So ask people to give some suggestions like that, so that you'll be getting traffic also, and also you'll be at the same time you'll be getting some suggestions also. Okay, so before writing any answers, see how others are writing also. Okay, you can also know how many viewed like that, right? So see how others are writing, how good they are about. Okay, so like this, you can give links. You can okay, you can also give your give links to your social media channels like YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, whatever it may be. You can navigate people from this forum posting or a Q&A website. Simply forum posting means online discussion sites. We'll be going to some online discussion sites and we'll be writing, or you'll be answering for their questions, or we'll be raising a question. Okay, so these both things are same: forum posting and Q&A websites. Q&A websites is nothing but like forum. Okay, right. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Next one is article submission. Here, we'll be submitting articles to whom, right? Here we write an article which is related to our business and add them to famous article submission directories. Okay, we'll be writing an article and we'll be submitting it to some article submission directories. By this, we can increase traffic, we'll be getting backlinks, and also we can create brand awareness. Okay, so let's go for this article submission sites. I'll go here and I'll search for the list of such article submission sites. You can go for Google also. Google also will give you many sites. Okay. So submit an article related to your website. Okay. So again, this article submission sites or directories will be having high domain authority or page rank, so that, okay, we'll be getting a backlink, so that our SERP rank also will increase. So these are all various article submission sites. Okay, again, the thing is, as you are getting a backlink, choose relevant, always write relevant articles. If you get a backlink from article which is relevant to your business or which is relevant to your website, then Google will think that it is a quality backlink. Okay, right? That's why we are asking to write an article that is relevant to our or your business. Okay, so github.com, Evernote, Wattpad, Article Bids, like this, there are various article submission sites. We have to register to them first. Okay, let me go to one submission site like Design Articles. I've used it before. GitHub, Evernote, Wattpad, these are also various sites. Okay, I will go to Design Articles. Here also, we have to write articles in a proper manner. Okay, choose your thing, choose your niche. So I'll be choosing about internet and business online, as this is my thing. So you can choose blogging, search engine marketing, whatever you want. You can choose. I'll simply choose. If you are writing an article about search engine marketing, choose it. If you are writing about blogging, you can choose this. So whatever you want, you can choose. Next, the thing is, you have to create a account here. We have to register here. Already I have an account. I'll open it. Okay, the articles, all the articles you wrote will be shown here. Okay, simply click on submit article. So now it will be asking you to fill all these details. So write article in a proper way. We have seen in on-page optimization, like it must have bolds, it must have italics, it must have internal and external links, and also maintain all these things. Okay, so maintain all these things, give proper title, proper description. Okay, so as we are giving a backlink, even if this article displays on the top also, people will be coming to our website. Okay, there is a chance. That's why write in a proper manner. You can give all these things. So it will be showing here. Okay, if you have any suggestions, it will show here. Okay, so they already exist on Agile articles. Okay, like this, it is showing. It's okay. So category. So you can choose the category and all. Okay, what kind of category it is related to. If it is there, it's okay. Internet and business online. Otherwise, you can choose others. If you have any subcategory also, you can choose this. Save. Okay, summary. Please give short introduction. Okay, it should be up to 2 to 5 sentences. Please give short introduction. And also body. So it is the main thing. Here you have to write your article. Some article submission sites will allow you, okay, up to words, whatever you can write. Okay, you can write up to your wish. But here in case of some articles, you must write up to minimum 400 words like that, I think. Let me show you. Okay, so see, you must write up in order to save this thing, you must write up to 400 words here. Okay, minimum 400 words are mandatory to publish this article. That's why I give a proper and lengthy description. And next thing is keywords. Okay, we have seen about keywords also. For what keywords your article should display, give that keywords also. You can give keywords with the help of comma separated things. So it will become one keyword. If you give a comma, it will become one keyword. In such way, it can give up to 100 characters. if someone searches for these keywords, my article also must appear. Okay, so like this, you can save this thing. Next, resource box. Okay, here you can see the description. So this is a place of your promotional content and call to action. Call to action means like submit, or it can be visit our site, buy now, okay, call us, contact us. All these are call to action things. Means we'll be provoking people to do this particular action. Okay, buy now, shop now, like that. Okay, visit us. Like that, these are all various things. You can also give such kind of things here. Call to action things. This is also important. And next thing is, you can also schedule this thing. Means, the thing is here, once you write an article, these people will review it. Okay, this particular directory people will review your article, and if they find that it is okay, it is good, so then that's when it gets published. Once it gets published, it will be getting a mail, confirmation mail that your article got published and all like that. Okay, and simply click on submit this article. So you have to complete all these things and you have to submit your article. You can also see the preview, how it will look at all. You can see the preview. See, I have wrote no content, that's why it is showing like that. Okay, and also the link will be shown like this. Okay, so write proper articles, because you'll be getting a backlink from here, and also your articles might get displayed on SERP, right? Any doubts here?
No, ma'am.
Next thing is a guest blog. Okay, so in article submission, we have seen that we'll be going to some directories and we'll be writing some articles there, so that we'll be getting a backlink in return. Now, in case of guest blogging, okay, what we do is, here we write an article for a website and we'll get a link for our website or a blog in return. Here we'll be writing articles for some other websites. In simple, here in case of article submission, we wrote an article in a directory and we got a backlink, right? But in case of guest blogging, here we'll be writing our articles in others' websites. Okay, as we are writing an article for them, in return we'll be asking for a backlink, or we'll be getting a backlink from them. Okay, so this is also known as guest posting, guest blogging, or guest posting. Okay, so we can also get paid for these things. Some people will pay for us. Okay, as we are writing articles for their website, they will also pay us. Okay, in this way also you can gain some money. Some will give backlinks, some will pay us, okay, based on the website's type at all. Okay, so there are various guest blogging sites. Okay, so here you can go and you can search here. The another thing is, as we want to get backlinks from relevant sites, okay, those sites should be relevant to our website, we must search for such kind of things. How should we search? Go to Google and simply type like write for us plus your keyword, digital marketing. Okay, or else you can search like digital marketing plus write for us. So if you search like this, you'll be displayed with all these sites. Okay, all these sites are related to digital marketing. In the same way, okay, they'll be asking to write for us. They'll be allowing other people to write articles in their website. Okay, so like this will be displayed with various things. If your field is related to something like technology, write for us plus technology, write for us plus automobiles. Okay, based on your niche, search here. Like this, will be getting all the relevant sites. Okay, that are relevant to all the sites that are relevant to your business or your website or your niche. Okay, so you can also see some sites like infobeat.com, and also there are many sites. You can go and search here if you want. So guest blogging, but the main thing is, as we want relevant websites, it's better to go and search there. Okay, as we are getting a backlink. Okay, these are all various sites. As we want a backlink and all, I'll suggest go for Google and search for it. Right. So now I'll choose one website. So every website will have some rules and regulations. Before writing an article for them, please read these instructions. See, they'll be giving some instructions. Okay, so we'll be receiving a lot of requests. Okay, so take 5 to 10 business days to respond. They will respond within 5 to 10 business days itself. So what all topics they will accept? See, they will be giving some guidelines for you. We'll be accepting articles in these topics. Okay, if you write about online innovation, blogging, email marketing, we'll be accepting those articles like such. Okay. And what do we publish? Digital marketing, education, opinions of expert and all these things are publishing. So before writing an article, you have to follow all these rules. Okay. So basics, first year article should have grammatical, should not have grammatical or language errors. You should not have grammatical or language errors. Okay. So your content should be informative and interactive and interesting. Okay, so you have to read all these instructions. It must have subheadings, quotes, images and all. Your article should be 800 to 1200 words itself. Your articles must contain 800 to 1200 words. Okay, so don't use irrelevant or copyright images. Don't make use of copyright images. Okay, the story should be unique. Means it should not be copied from anywhere. It should be posted in our blog only. No one should not have posted it anywhere else. You should not give your article to others also like that. Okay, you should include your bio and all. Okay, do not promote any service or product in your story. They are clearly saying that you should not promote anything. Okay, so like this, based on all these guidelines, you have to write an article for them, because your article will also impact their website's reputation, their website's traffic and many other things. That's why they'll be providing some guidelines. It is absolutely correct. Okay, so follow all these guidelines. If you want to write any article, leave your name, email, and on what topic you want to write an article, please leave your message. If you have any basic info, like if you have written some 1 page or 2 pages like that, you can give that, choose, leave your article here. Okay, so that they will go through it once and they'll check it whether it is okay or not, and they'll send you a mail. They'll contact you through email. So if it is okay for them, they'll simply say yes, you can go on and write an article for us. If not, simply they'll say no, we are not currently posting such kind of articles. Please choose these kind of topics like that, they'll suggest you. Okay, so search for such kind of websites and write an article. Some websites may pay you, and in return some websites will give you a backlink to your website also. Okay, so in this way, you have to search and you have to go for guest posting or guest blogging. Here you will be writing articles in others' websites. In return, we'll be paid for writing articles, or we'll be getting a back. Right. So let's go for next topic. The next one is QR code. Okay, so have you seen QR codes anywhere? On any posters you might have seen. You might have seen them on any biscuit packets like that. If you want to visit our website, if you go on to get more info, scan this code. Yes, yes, right. So here also we can create such kind of QR codes and paste them on our video subtitles. Like, okay, first slide of our presentation, first slide of video. When you are posting your image on Facebook or social media platforms, you can simply place a QR code there. So you can simply generate a QR code within a minute or less than that. So there are some tools like QR code generator. Okay, simply go there. So you can create a QR code for a text. It can be for URL, your phone number, whatever it may be, you can create a QR code. Okay, simply go for URL. I'll give my website name, or simply copy and paste the URL. So if you see, on the right hand side, the QR code is changed. Okay, so like this, you'll get a QR code. Now, if anyone scan this QR code, you'll be navigating to digiready.in. Okay, you can try it also. If I change this thing, the QR code also will change. odmt.in. See, if someone scans it now, so you can scan it with your phone like that, you'll be directly navigating to your to this ODMT website. Okay, so you can also take this and different sizes. Okay, so 100 pixels, 200 pixels, 50 pixels, like that. Okay, so you can also save this tier. Okay, save or download this tier. Okay, so within less than a minute or within 10 seconds, you can create your own QR code. But the thing is, with the help of this, you'll not be getting a backlink. Okay, please remember that you'll not be getting a backlink. But the thing is, as people are becoming lazy and more lazy, okay, so if you provide them with a QR code, if they want more info, they'll simply scan it and they'll go to our website. We are just making them easy. Okay, we are just showing them an easy way to reach our business. That's it. Okay, in order to gain traffic, it is one of the best ways. Okay, you can use this QR codes while promoting your posts on social media or for all the things wherever you go, you can use this thing. Okay, that's about a QR code generator. Remember that you'll not be getting a backlink here. Just it is simply we are making people easy in order to reach our business. Okay, we are making a way for people to easily reach our business. That's it. Next thing is a business reviews. Okay, so what is this business reviews? Have you seen Google reviews for a business? So if you search for any institute or search for anything on Google, you'll be seeing some reviews there. Okay, so I'll search for something like ratings and reviews. So have you seen such kind of thing? See, these are ratings. If you click here, there might be some reviews also. See, it's Google My Business. Okay, see, these are all reviews. Okay, so more Google reviews. If you go for reviews, there is no review system. Okay, there is only one thing. Okay, so have you seen these things? There are some ratings.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
So these Google reviews for a business also help improve search ranking. If you are getting good rating and good reviews, okay, so we'll be ranking on top. Our ranking will increase. Okay, Google also will consider this. Customer reviews also matter. For example, if you go for Amazon or Flipkart or whatever it may be, if you want to buy a product, okay, even though you have a good idea about it, you'll go for the ratings and reviews. Am I correct? If the ratings and reviews are good, then only you'll be clear about buying that product. You'll be getting an idea to buy that product. Am I correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, in the same way, these reviews are also important. Okay, so make sure if you keep your business on Google or if you have a physical location or like such, okay, please make sure that your reviews and ratings are good. So if you get a negative review or like such, please go for them. Please comment on their review and try to solve their problem. Don't delete such kind of reviews. Every business will get both positive and negative reviews. If you solve their issue or if you go through their problems and if you try to solve them, we'll get more reputation. And next thing is profile creation or press release. Okay, what is this profile creation or press release? It is simple. Okay, here we create profiles in different platforms such as forum sites, social networking sites, web 2.0 sites, okay, etc. We have seen all these things. We have created profiles in various sites, okay, and we have been advertising ourselves. So in every site or in every platform, we'll be giving our business details and website link so that people can easily research. Okay. So in simple way, we have to create profiles in various platforms and we have to generate brand awareness in order to drive some traffic to our business. Okay. That's about profile creation and press release. Okay. And next thing is infographic submission. Sorry, Google My Business. Okay, so what is this Google My Business? So if you see here, this is not an SEO result. Okay, this is a local listing. Right, this is a local listing. As these institutes are nearer to me, it is showing me this thing. If you have a physical location of your business, then how to display your business like this? okay, on Google, if you want to display your business location and all, then how to do that? Again, one thing. So local listings are more often shown to user as they are nearer to that particular user. There is more advantage with this thing, having this thing. Okay, it will be shown more often to the users. Okay, so in order to create such kind of local listings and all, you have to create a Google My Business account and you have to register your business there. So Google, go to Google My Business. Okay, so manage now. You can also create an account if you are serious. Now just I'll show you. Okay, so I already have an account with Teams. Let me go for a new one. Right, once you click on manage, you'll be shown like this. Okay, so then give your business name. See here, it is showing me an image like your business will be shown up like this and all. Okay, people can write reviews about your business. You can add photos, you can add about, means your info. I'll give some business name like DigiReady. Okay, so next thing is, this is the business name. If you click on next, okay, we'll be agreeing to all these terms and conditions by default. Next, then you have to choose your business category. What category is your business related to? It is something related to education or digital marketing or whatever it may be. I'll choose something. Next, give proper details, guys. Give proper details. Don't create irregular details. As it is listed in Google, so go for right thing. So do you want to add a location and all? So if you want an add, if you want to add a location like Google Map, okay, so now we have seen a local listing of, along with the map, right? So if you want to display such kind of maps, click on yes. So you can choose the address here, right? So choose the state also. Next, so in this way you can choose your location also. So see, on the map will be shown like this. So if you want to add or remove this thing, or if you want to change the address, you can simply change this map view or satellite view, whatever you want, you can choose. Okay, so like this, choose proper location, click on next. Okay, do you serve customers outside this location? So if you provide services outside this location also, please click on yes. Okay, so if it is like Zomato or Swiggy, like that, they'll provide services outside of their location also. Am I correct? So if you are such kind of business, then choose yes. If not, choose no. So you have to give your phone number, you have to give your website URL. If you have a website, okay, if you have a website, you can give your URL. If not, you can create a website also, it seems. Okay, but again, it will be like a web 2.0 sites, or if you can also choose, I don't need a website. If you don't need a website, I'm okay with the physical platform and all, then you can simply go with, I don't need a website. I'll give some phone number and all. So website, your www.digiready.in. Give proper info, guys. So as people will be navigating to your location, sorry, to your website and not your destination URL. Click on next. So simply click on finish, your thing will be completed. And it is not that easy, guys. Okay, this is not that easy. You'll be getting a post. Okay, see, postcard by mail. You'll be getting a post which contains some code. Okay, it will be mailed to your address, means it will be sent to your physical address. You have to collect this particular post and you have to enter that code here, then only your local listing will get activated. So they'll be confirming whether you gave a correct location or not. Okay, as Google will not dissatisfy their customers. Okay, Google will try always to keep their customers on top, keep their visitors on top.
No,
it will send a postcard to your physical location address. It will be giving some address like Hyderabad, your PIN code, okay? It will be sending in order to verify your location, whether it is correct or not, like that. Okay, that card, that postcard will be containing some code. You have to enter that code here. Okay, it may arrive within 12 days like that. If you click on mail, after that it will come in 12 days. It might take 12 days to arrive, it seems. Okay, or else you can choose simply verify later. Afterwards also you can come here and you can verify later. Okay, so if you want to add any services, like what kind of services you provide and all, you can also add such kind of things. Okay, so just click on save like that. You can give about your info and all, and which business hours you are open. Okay, you can see that when you click on any business, it will show Saturdays holiday, Sundays holiday. It is open from 6 a.m. to evening 5 p.m. like that. You can choose on what days our business will be open, on what days it will be closed, from which timings it will be open and all. You can choose, see, opens it and closes it, which timing. Okay, like that you can choose. So I'm choosing some timing, so it's okay. Save. So you can also give some information about your business. You can skip this thing. Okay, afterwards also you can write it out, but give proper info, that what you teach, what products you provide. Okay, where, in which areas you'll be providing services, what kind of things you'll be teaching and all, like this, give proper info. So you can add photos also. So you might have seen all these things. You might be scrolling the photos and seeing that particular business photos and all. You can also give a review and all also. Right, your profile is almost ready. So like this, your business, Google My Business account will appear, okay? You can verify it now. Click on verify now. Okay, you'll be getting it. They'll be sending a postcard to you, which contains the code. So you can also give your business mail. So if anyone sends you any kind of reviews, like if anyone writes any positive or negative reviews, you can see them here. Okay, once you verify your account, you can see what all the reviews and ratings you got and all. Okay, and also you can write about your business, and here it will show how your business will get displayed. Okay, so like this, you'll be shown with your business name, you'll be shown with your map where your business is present. They'll show how many ratings you have, how many things you have, and all these things you can see. Okay, so I think you people know about all these things. Okay, you can also add a logo, you can also add description. Okay, many things you can do with this. Okay, you can also display your products. If you are selling your products, you can display it here. You can add your photos. You can give some messages and all, but you have to verify for that. Okay, if you have multiple locations in the same city, if you are providing services in multiple locations, you can add multiple locations here. See, add location. By clicking on add location, you can add multiple locations. You can add multiple websites. If you want others also to see your Google My Business account, or in order to manage your thing, you want another user, you can add users also here. Okay, if you want any help, you can go for support and all. You can link multiple accounts here. Okay, if you have any accounts, you can link them here. Like this, you can do various things. Google My Business is very helpful. Because Google always mostly tends to show local listings. Okay, local listings when compared to SEO results. Because people, if anyone searches like hospitals near me, okay, is it better to show text results or local listings, which contains a map?
Local listings.
Obviously local listings, schools near me, hospitals near me, or any institutes near me, digital marketing institutes like that. If people search for any particular or specific thing, Google will tend to show mostly these kind of local listings only. That's why please create such kind of things also. It will be very helpful for you. Also, you can improve your SERP ranking with the help of good reviews and all. Okay, so you can see insights, like how many people came to your business with the help of this, through this and all. You can see all these things. Okay, so simply if you want to delete your Google My Business account, you can go to info and you can simply mark it as permanently closed if you are not running it anymore. Otherwise, you can simply click on remove listing also. We have a store code, labels and all. If anyone are promoting any kind of products and all, they might be having a code and all. You have to add them also. Okay, so if you click on remove listing, see it is saying that if your business is closed, then you should mark it as permanently closed first. Okay, right? You'll not be able to recover this listing's data. Okay, you can transfer your ownership also, it says. Okay, you can simply click on remove, close business, then you can remove this listing also. Right, first you have to mark it as closed, my business is closed, then you have to remove your thing, right? So please try for creating such kind of Google My Business account also if you are having any physical business. You can give your house details on all also, no issues. Okay, so okay. This is about various of page optimization techniques. Okay, now let's go to Google and check once. Okay, so what kind of listing it is?
Image submission.
You have to identify these things. So if you see, there are various SEO filters. Okay, among them, most of them are related to off-page optimization. Okay. What kind of thing is this?
Google My Business.
Yes, Google My Business, which is appearing on top. And next thing is this thing. Ad post.
Ad post.
It's classified submissions. They are known as classified submissions. Okay. What is this thing? Just dial. Yes, same. It is also classified submission. Just dial, Flipkart, OLX, all these things are okay. Classified submissions related to ad posting. What is this thing? This is an SEO result. Okay, this is an SEO result. Okay. What is some kind of social media posting? What is this? This is also classified posting. So what is this?
Video submission.
Yes, it is video submission. Yes, you have to, you should be able to find these things. So this is a kind of image submission. See, some people might have submitted their images on Google and all. Let's go and see some other ones also. So the thing is, though you don't get a park link, okay, from some sites, so you'll be obviously getting traffic from them. You'll be getting good traffic, and your thing will be displayed on top of SERP. This is also classified submission. See, when compared to SEO results and ads, these things are getting displayed on top. Okay, as they have good domain authority and page authority, in the same time, there are very old sites. Okay, so they'll be obviously displayed on top. Image submission again. So, right, this is also classified submission, video submission. You might also see some sites like Web 2.0 sites. Okay, again, classified submission. This is image submission. Okay, see, when compared to other results, SEO results, most of the results are from off-page optimization. So that's why don't neglect off-page optimization. Okay, even on-page optimization might fail sometimes, as I said before, but off-page optimization will give you a best results in long run. Okay, so that's about today's class.